request for justice for Margaret Njeri died at the age of 22 after the actions of a police officer who attempting to stop a boda boda rider threw a gun which hit her, and she's now dead. And the family, the mother has been in the news. She's in a story here on page 5 in The Nation today. And she said she'll not bury her daughter up until this officer is, one, arrested. He's yet to be arrested. In this day and age, we've not seen any of this, police officers, whether it's the acting IG, whether it's the CS, come out to speak on this particular matter. Does that worry you, Wenda, when we see these kind of things happen and that it's believed that he's being shielded, he's been moved to protect him? What does this tell you?
I think it is it's a bad show.
Absolutely.
Especially if even being called upon to write a basic statement to just explain, this is what I was trying to do, this is eventually what happened, so that the country, the immediate person has some explanation. So it gives credence to the thinking that the fellow is being shielded, especially when the body is dead. Even me, if I was to shoot somebody, even accidentally, even my own child, the police would come and tell us, please, Mr. Weather, come and tell us, how did it happen? Then from what I tell them, they can weigh whether it was an accident, they can weigh whether I'm culpable. So failing to do so, my view would have been that before we arrest the culprit, there are a few others at the top who should be arrested and charged with neglect of basic duty. And the law is clear on that. So it is wrong. And we needed to have taken action. But again, don't politicize and say jubilee. Those are basic officers down there that you can force or even amend more laws in parliament so that it is done. But you saw some of the laws, the security amendment laws, you are all up in arms. Some would address those issues.
Okay.
They would address
as long as they're constitutional.
As long as they aren't constitutional. Yeah. Now, the family, of course, needs justice. Some justice. And the starting point really is to have this officer record a settlement, as Andrews has said. But more importantly, this is a demonstration of the level of impunity in the police service. It's something we have been talking about for ages now. It's something needs to be done insofar as police reforms are concerned.
And link for me that with the Boynet and his imminent, appointment to that position of IG. When you talk about reforms, are you confident he'll be the man to deliver that?
if you went through the Hansard, you'll see how vigorously opposed his nomination, that gentleman, because I don't think he fits the bill. Something was terribly wrong in his nomination and eventual appointment. I think he was basically being brought on board to fill in the gap left by a fellow KU or Marakwet, which is totally wrong. We are going to see problems going forward in the police service.
Justice for Njeri.
Yeah, I think it's a very sad story, and again a demonstration of impunity. And it is not just the only case, and may she rest in peace. I was reading yesterday of a lady in I think Migori, who was kicked in the belly by a policeman when she was 6 months pregnant, had a miscarriage. And these are some of the stories that are either not reported. We are actually assuming these are the few that just are reported. There are many that are not even reported. And we have seen people power in this country. I think the removal of Kimayu himself, I would say, from the helm of the police was actually a demonstration of the people pressure. And I'm expecting the same for this new nominee for IG position, because it has happened. And the outcry you've seen with the people, I've seen even the human rights groups down at the coast come up in arms and, you know, deliberate on this issue of Njeri. And it's not related. The same thing with Pumwani. Children that were apparently dead on arrival, then the twins, the DNA has shown they are not even twins. These cover-ups by institutions, and they are now finding their way even into parliament. Already that issue of Pumwani is in parliament, is in the Senate. And I'm sure even this one for Njeri will get its way, because it has to be advocated by someone. It has to be said. And I'll be looking forward to actually making sure that it can be delivered. That person can be shown, even face. Because now she's saying, they say it's this one, then it's not this one. The cover-up is massive. It has to be unearthed. And if these things continue happening, it again goes back to dent the image of the police. And the person who takes the responsibility are the people at the helm.
Links on
yesterday with Margaret Njeri, we raised the issue with Cabinet Secretary for Interior. Kanini Kega and I raised the issue because she hails from Peketoni, but originally from Nyeri. Mm-hmm. And therefore, we first and foremost, the more incidental thing is the fact that she was in the ICU for almost 2 months. Mm-hmm. And plus, so there's a 2 million bill,
yeah,
which we have asked the government through Nkaiseri to offset. So he did say that Kanini and I should write a request, and we will do that, because the family had made that request directly to myself. So we are going to ask Kanini. I mean, Kanini and I will be processing that request by Wednesday, as General Kaiseri did indicate. The policeman has gone into hiding. I genuinely believe on this one, there is no real interest for the state to protect the police person. Mm. I think he's somewhere hiding, I think. And eventually, I think there are orders for his prosecution on murder prosecutions. And I think that those prosecutions will take place. He can run, but he can hide for as long as it takes. We will prosecute him. But I think in the interim, let's help support the family.
Yeah, there's a number actually that's a Safaricom. Yeah, it's 317077. That's a Safaricom pay bill number. Mm. For well wishers.
Ideally, I think we need to help them throughout the process. So, if the government can take up the bill. Those are the issues, like those are the contributions will help in funeral arrangements and shipment of the body.
Yeah.
And I think, but I want to tell the police in particular, these are some of the areas where they just become totally excessive. You know, there was really, even if it was he swung the butt of the gun,
it's still wrong.
And this other, and even if it's the border driver who ducked and hit this Margaret, or who has been unconscious from that date. I think whatever the justification, it did not require that level of force. That was really malicious.
Just something on IG.
Yes.
I think the incoming IG, already they are puncturing him by vilifying him, especially according to them, he does not have a stack of degrees. The one who entered a stack of degrees, we have a preoccupation with a stack of degrees. Let us allow the new IG, let us welcome him. Give him a chance.
The degrees is not working.
Even this one, if he doesn't have, let's give him a chance.
Our issues are not degrees. No, there, we'll come into that. If you look at the handset,
we raised
all those issues about vetting and credibility, integrity, impartiality, operational.